week we started to the first half of chapter 2 of Jeremiah the prophet. ותמיד יש את המרבות הגדול הזה, איך אפשר לכנס פרק שלם בשביל אחר? ואני כל הזמן לא מצליח. And this struggle always. But I'm trying to at least take one chapter and put it into one lesson. But it's just too big. ובקשה, בוא נלך. אני אסכם את השיר סדר, את העיקר בשיר סדר, ונעריך על הפסוקים ונגיע למה שנקרא קיסר עשר, לאן שנגיע. So just give a little summary of what we had last week about the first half of this chapter, and then we're moving into the second half. My name is Neil, and I'm warning you. הסיכום של שבוע שעבר היום יהפוך להיות השיעור של היום. The summary of last week may become today's lesson.
כן, חשוב.
Because it's really important.
אז נראה איך אני מביא את השיעור הזה.
Let's see how God is going to guide our lesson this morning. ירמיה פונה אל העם, אין שכבוד גבורת אלוהים לא נחסמים. Jeremiah turns to his people, to our people that have seen the greatness and the power of God for decades, for centuries. הוא מוכיח עצמו כנביא אמת. And Jeremiah has already proven himself as a genuine prophet of God. ואז השאלה שאנחנו שואלים, איך ייתכן? באמת איך ייתכן שכל כך הרבה אנשים שטענו את כוחו הריבוני של אלוהים, It was when we read what Jeremiah was to say, we ask ourselves the question, how can it be that so many people that have seen the power of God and that have experienced His miracles, after such a short time, they turn and they begin to worship idols and forget about God? And the same thing we see when Joshua, the great leader, when he knew he was going to die, he's talking to the people. He gets them all together and he tells them, listen, you have now seen all these incredible miracles that God did in conquering the land, going through the Jordan, all these incredible things, but I warn you, one generation from now, there's a danger that you already forget about God. So how can that be, even in Joshua's time, that he already knew that this was probably going to come?
איך אפשר לשתות ממקור מים חיים, לומר זה מים חיים, וללכת לחתור בורות של הלכויות מים? איך אפשר?
So back to Jeremiah's parables, how is it possible that here you have a person that has just drank from a beautiful spring with living water, beautiful, fresh, bubbling, clean water, and that person just turns around after drinking and goes and starts to dig in the dirt and says, I'm going to make myself a water well and I'm going to collect heavy rainwater and, that's what I'm going to drink. Why would any sane person do that? Now there are a few possibilities why people would act like that.
The Quran
and they're all bad.
אבל אלה התשובות שאני מכיר מדבר אלוהים.
But those are the answers to this question which I can find in the Word of God.
מי שסוטה מדרכו של אלוהים, אופציה א', כן, אופציה ראשונה, מי שסוטה, או כל אלה שסוטים מדרך אלוהים, הוא מתמידים בדרך הרעה. מתמידים בדרך הרעה.
If you have someone who leaves the Word of God and then continues consistently to walk in ways that are not the ways of God, to walk in the bad ways, consistently, just keeps on doing it, that is obviously a person who has never been saved in the first place. It's a person who may look like a believer for a while, but he never was. because the fruit tells us what tree we're looking at, right?
אם אתה הולך להיות עץ בננה, ועץ בננה אומר, אני תפוז!
If you pass by a banana tree and it says, I'm an orange tree.
מגיע הנה של פרחת הבננה, ומרץ את תפוז הבננה,
then you can just tell a tree, wait, it's not the right season, I can't tell what you are. But then you wait a few weeks or a few months, and then you see what fruit is on it. That tree that said he's an orange tree, it's full of bananas. So he obviously isn't an orange tree.
But a banana, banana should be my tell me.
Well, a banana, it doesn't matter what you say about yourself.
And I think I said, Adam, Baba, Amar, Ami, Yaldo, Si, Yeshua, Ami, Yaldo, Si, Elohim, Rabotai, אתה צריך להיות דומה לאבא. אני אפילו, חלק מהגנים צריכים להיראות, אני מצטער.
And the person says, I am a child of God.
And when he gets and he says, I am a child of God,
then the genes of God need to be seen in that person's life. It needs to be visible. Or it needs to be a little bit like God in some ways.
וגם חלק די גדול מעם ישראל נעלם למשה.
And it is the same with the people of Israel. There's a big section of the people of Israel who have never been saved.
They're not believers. יצאו ממצרים, חצו את ים סוף, עמדו להר סיני, אכלו את המן, שתו מצור, המים, והשתחוו לבעל. מה אתה רוצה?
They came out of Egypt, they went through the Red Sea, they ate the manna, they were at Mount Sinai, they heard the voice of God speaking to them from the mountain, and they made a golden calf or worship bear. That means part of their experience was for nothing. So the first answer to the question is, why would people who have drunk from the living water turn and make themselves water holes which don't hold any water? Why would they do that? Well, on the spiritual level, there are people who have perhaps professed that they are believers, but they never were. They were never saved.
Now,
there is another possibility why people would behave with that. It can be that a saved believer, a truly born again believer, falls into sin. That happens, right? And sometimes those erring brothers remain in that minefield far too long, much longer than they wish them that they would be in there. And sometimes believers make a decision in a moment, and that decision leaves a scar for the rest of their life. It's cannot be erased.
חיי חסידות הוא התמדה לחיות ולגור ליד מקור מים חיים זו משימה בלתי אפשרית לבן אדם.
Now, perfect, a perfect, or a life of perfect godliness, a life where the believer is always next to this spring of living water all the time, that's impossible. We're humans, it's humanly impossible.
לדבר על לנצח כל הזמן את אהבת הבשר,
it means that that person would be 100% perfect in always having the victory over what his flesh wants. He would be perfectly able to always resist any urge and any drive that wants him to do something that God doesn't like. That person would be perfectly able to withstand any pressure from society to conform with society or to conform with
a circle of people that surround him.
Yanit ma'atzmi v'lichot ke'korban chai kadosh v'ratzu l'Elohim.
That person will be perfectly able at all times to bow to himself and be a living sacrifice to God at all times.
Yitvodot al kol chet v'lachzor b'tshuva kama.
That person would always, immediately, instantly ask forgiveness for every sin and receive forgiveness.
תשכחו מזה, רק אלוהים יכול לעשות זה בשבילנו.
But there is no person like that. There is not such a perfect person like that. But God can help us to be at least in that direction.
רק בכוח רוח הקודש אפשר לעשות את מה שציינתי.
Where all the things that are mentioned, that are described, they are only able by the help and by the power of the Holy Spirit.
זה דבר שאנחנו צריכים להתכסות בו כל היום, ולא רק תמיד בטמפרטורות בחוץ.
It is something that we like to cover ourselves with, but something that we like to put on at all times. Not just when we feel like, not just when it's cold outside. No, this has to be on us all the time.
אז אופציה ראשונה, מדוע אנשים עוזבים מקום מלאכים?
So, first option, why would people leave the source of living water?
No, 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 it's all.
Because they were never saved.
Option two, the second option, second possibility.
Kusi, nifelat, kogelim nifelim. Because they fell into sin, and that happens to all of us.
We are only asked to be saved. You are doing it. As the kelim are not only looking at the law, to be sin nisamer liyad abeir azu shel meim chaim. Liyad adon yisuei masir okol hazman.
Now, what are the tools God gives us? They help us to remain as close as possible to the spring of living water, as close as possible to the Lord Jesus Christ Himself.
Ruach HaKodesh.
First tool is the Holy Spirit.
Yet Nefeim.
And, of course, being saved in the first place.
Yet Nefeim. Yet Nefeim. Yet Nefeim. Yet Nefeim. Yet Nefeim. Yet Nefeim. Yet Nefeim.
To be called a child of God, not just because that's popular, but because God is really our favor.
ואז יש לנו הנחיה בכתובים איך עלינו לתת לרוח הקודש למלא אותנו לשלוט בחיינו.
And then we have instructions in the Bible of how to let the Holy Spirit, how to make it possible for the Holy Spirit to fill us and to guide us.
תבינו, כל אחד מאיתנו מודע לזה שעלו לפעול.
Now, I'm sure that everybody here knows that he is prone to fall.
מה אנחנו יכולים לעשות כדי להתרחק מסדר המוקשים הזה?
So what can we do in order to be as far as possible from the brownfield?
או יותר נכון, בתוך הבאר של מים חיים כל הזמן.
What can we do so we will be inside in that well of living water, or in that spring of living water? All the time. First tool is, besides the Holy Spirit, alright? Second tool is reading the Word of God, being inside the Word of God as much as possible. Remember that one of the tasks of the Holy Spirit is to remind us of the Word of God. But if we never read the Word of God, the Holy Spirit has nothing to remind us of. That would be a sad scenario.
And if I show, I see bait, you have barrels, the Lord is not in the Lord, the Lord is.
Because, I mean, it is possible, theoretically, that you build your house next to the well of living water, but you never drink of it. You live next to it, but you never drink of it. But you go out first, even though here it's bubbling right next to you.
אז לא זה לשתות מים חיים כל הזמן.
So then, what does it mean to drink of this living water? What is it, what do we have to do in order to do that?
לאכול את דבר אלוהים.
What it is to ingest the word of God.
לימוד קבוע ומתמשך, לא פעם בשבוע לקרוא חצי פסוק ולהגיד, אני כל השבוע חושב עליו, זה דיאטה רצחנית.
And that means to invest a lot of good quality time with the Word of God, reading and studying. It's not that you just once a week you read a verse and then you say, yeah, I'm meditating on that verse for the rest of the week. That's diet. It's not good.
ואם תאכל סטייק טוב של קילו אחד, אתה לא יכול להשאיר אותו שבוע שלם על השולחן וכל פעם לקחת ביס. הוא יתקלקל, אתה תהיה רעב. זה לא דיאטה נכונה.
כל יום שלוש מנות! Even if you have a good steak, like one kilo of steak, if you leave it lying on the table, and every 2 days you eat a tiny little bag, what's going to happen to that steak? It's going to rot. It's not going to do you any good. You have to have a healthy diet every day.
יש אנשים שקוראים, אבל לא מאפשרים לאלוהים לשכון בלב. לא מאפשרים לאלוהים לכתוב את המילה על ליבם. הם חושבים שהם יודעים.
ואלוהים קוראים!
ועושים אחרת. זה לא לקרות.
לקרוא ולימוד.
ולאפשר לאלוהים ללמוד אותך ולשנות אותך.
Well, those who do read, but then they don't live it out in their lives. They read the truth, but they don't do the truth. They read the truth, but they don't obey the truth. So that reading isn't very beneficial. It needs to be put into practice.
Stein, Tfilah, Tfilah, Tfilah.
Now there's another important tool that keeps us close to the world living water, and that is prayer. A lot of prayer, being in touch with God.
Tfilah, Tfilah, Tfilah.
Prayer, and prayer, and prayer again.
איך אתם קוראים לזוג שכל הזמן הולך ביחד ואף פעם לא מדבר?
How would you call a couple that you see walking together all the past time, but they're never talking to each other?
מי רוצה נישואים כאלו?
Who wants to live in such a marriage?
מי רוצה נישואים כאלו?
Anyone wants a marriage like that?
תודה.
גם אלוהים לא. Now also God doesn't want such a relationship with us.
התפילה זה לא שלא יודע מה אנחנו חושבים ומה אנחנו רוצים.
Now it doesn't mean that God needs this prayer. He knows what we have in our hearts and what we think. He knows everything.
זה בשבילנו.
But it's for us. We need this prayer.
זה בשבילנו לומר, אנחנו פעים בכל ולזהות
להוא
על מה לבקשתנו.
It is for us to express to God, God, we need you. We're helpless. We're lost without you. And it's for us to then expect and see the answer to those prayers.
Shalosh Tziyut.
Third tool, next tool is obedience.
Karata, Hedanta, Nikastaka, Tatsi.
You have read, you have understood, you have asked for the power and the ability to do it. Now go ahead and do it.
ללמוד תפילות זו אמונה של סבים. הסבים יודעים יותר טוב מאיתנו את אלוהים, אבל לא מצייתים לו.
But the faith that is not combined with obedience. And that's the faith, the Bible calls it the faith of the demons. The demons also believe, right? But they don't do, they don't obey.
אז אחד זה ללמוד, שתיים תפילה, שלוש תפילות.
So we have reading and studying, we have prayer, and then the third one, which is obedience.
But
then there's a fourth one, the last one. Listen carefully.
Itchabrut.
Number four is fellowship.
Itchabrut in la'aminim bogrim.
Fellowship with grown-up believers, mature believers.
V'yachas shel kavod v'aracha le'bet Elohim. ולאלו שפועלים בבית אלוהים. תשימו לב מה שאני אומר, אני לא זה מנסיון. התחברות עם מאמינים בוגרים, וכבוד והערכה לאלו שעמלים בדבר אדוני. ואני לא אומר את זה לאחוז בקרמות המזבח, תכף המזבח בדיוק למה אני מתכוון.
And that has a few ingredients. It's one, it's the fellowship, being together with believers, but it also includes a
Yachas. Relationship.
A relationship of giving honor to the house of God and giving honor to those who labor in the house of God. And by no means saying that so that somebody should honor me. That's not the thing at all, but I'm going to explain why I make this an important point.
לקבלת ספרון מידע ללא תשלום,